Me this afternoon. My name is Sheila Dalford. I'd just like to welcome each and every one of you and to make a few brief remarks about my intention to run. I'd like to start by indicating that I am a proud resident of Pennsylvania, the state where I was born, the state where I received my education from kindergarten through law school, the state where I have lived and worked for most of my 54 years, and the state where today, in the capital rotunda of the place I call my own, Pennsylvania, I formally announce that I am a candidate for Congress in Pennsylvania's 17th Legislative District. The 17th District is vast, comprising over 1,700 square miles of beautiful Pennsylvania countryside, small towns, hamlets, rivers, streams, mountains, and valleys. It includes the counties of Dauphin, Lebanon, Schuylkill, and portions of Berks and Perry. And its diversity in land and natural beauty is equally reflected in its people, who come from a wealth of backgrounds and cultures, and whose hard work, values, and religious and community bonds have formed strong families, strong social alliances, and strong communities for generations. Indeed, it is the hard work of the men and women of Central PA that helped build America generations ago. My family shares in that work and in those traditions. The rhythms of our communities form a bond across the vastness of the geographic spaces. The challenges and opportunities of time and place and circumstance bear a tremendous similarity that cuts across cultural, social, and economic boundaries. They are the same rhythms of life that compel a young mother to search out an after-school program for her children, a father to find a better place to live for his family, or a retired mill worker to go to community college to obtain a new job skill. Those same rhythms of life exist all over our district. In each and every county and community, we are people who are more alike than not, and we share the same challenges and opportunities for creating better lives for our families and for ourselves. The farmer in Lebanon, the state employee, the steel worker, truck driver, teacher, nurse. Wait for that to get through. We all share a common core of concerns and challenges that impact our lives, and we must find the common ground to bridge the geographic, demographic, and historical gaps that exist between and among us. To do so requires leadership that brings us together around common challenges and forges new ideas from our collective strength around job growth, manufacturing, green economies, education, health, and housing for all people of all ages and of all backgrounds. This is why I stand today for Congress in PA 17. Because I am a leader whose resume and record conveys my capacity, commitment, courage, and compassion to our families and our future. I bring to our district, PA 17, real leadership of the type required in this day and time. A brief summary of my resume bears this out. I graduated with high honors from LaSalle University and obtained my law degree from the University of Pennsylvania Law School. Since receiving my law degree, I have also completed certificate courses in a variety of areas at Rutgers University, Harvard, MIT, and Radcliffe. I have over 25 years of experience in the areas of education law, finance, and policy, having served as chief counsel to two organizations, AESPA and New Jersey School Boards Association, and as president of the New Jersey Association of School Attorneys. I've also co-authored a book on education law and policy, and I've written many articles and lectured extensively on education law, finance, and policy over the past several years. In addition, I was a part of a very, very important legal challenge in New Jersey that successfully changed the manner in which schools were funded in the state and that pushed for real education reform in all 498 districts there. The challenges we fought to reform included the excessive reliance upon the local property tax, and it's the very same issue that we are challenged to really change today in Pennsylvania. It is the very same issue that is challenging Pennsylvania homeowners today. Currently, I am a member of the Pennsylvania State Board of Education, and I have just completed a series of articles on a variety of matters as a guest journalist for the Harrisburg Patriot News. I have served as the president of the YWCA of Greater Harrisburg and as president of United Way of the Capital Region. I have served on two task forces established by the Pennsylvania Department of Health and was a member of the Pennsylvania Commission on Women. I currently serve on the board of the Education Policy Leadership Council, and I am the co-founder of the only charter school within Harrisburg, the Sylvan Heights Science Charter School, which is a K-4 comprehensive public school located in the heart of the city. I have been married for 29 years, and my husband, Les Ford, and I have 3 children. Les is a former steelworker, a card-carrying member of United Steelworkers, and a Teamster as well. In short, I have a consolidated resume that reflects a long-standing professional and personal commitment to public service. My family reflects the culture and community of Pennsylvania. My great-grandparents owned a dairy farm, and after selling the farm and becoming shopkeepers for many years, they bought another farm in their retirement. My mother's family worked in the mills in Stilton and taught school there. Other families have lived across central PA for generations. My family instilled values of honesty, hard work, and integrity and courage in me, my 5 siblings, and my 25 cousins. They taught me to become a leader through example. They showed strength of leadership of the sort we need now in the 17th. The type of leadership I know and I understand, and as is reflected in my resume. The type of leadership that will lead us into a brighter future and help to bring jobs, better education, new energy to our communities. I have to say that healthcare is a critical issue of our time, perhaps the most critical issue of our time, impacting our families and our communities. Too many families are without healthcare, or they are relegated to a desperate and demeaning status by healthcare insurers who focus on profits instead of people. I am saddened to say that on this issue and others, our current Congressman, Tim Holden, does not bring the caliber of courageous leadership that reflects capacity, commitment, and compassion to the people of the 17th, and we are suffering.